There's a compromise of three things that have to be made. There's the density that has to be got into this area. There's the green space that needs to be preserved. And there's also the air corridor to worry about. But I think the air corridor is the least important because, quite frankly, in a very short time, there's going to be no air corridor the way things are going. I mean, unless they can find good electric planes to be coming in. But secondly, I think using tall buildings, as Timmy said, with the supports below and leaving the green space open. And another thing that I find very important is the green space should be maintained by the city. It should be owned by the city, so any buildings that go on there will be basically the building will be owned by the owner of the building, but the green space is the city's and it will be parkland. So, okay. And I think we should go quite high to get the density in there and not take away land.
Okay, thank you.
I just want to add a rush to complete this project. It's going to take many years, but there should be a little rush to design it because what you need is you need a complete package to offer to people. And there's got to be a lot of forward and creative thinking to get that done. Every time you cut a corner, you're basically missing an opportunity. Anything you throw out of the design is just something that doesn't happen. And we need things to happen in this city. Toronto is a fabulous city. It's a world city, but it's not yet a world-class city. It's a city with people from all over the world, all of which are not really represented highly in here. And we have to bring them into the package too. There's so many fabulous ideas that out there in the city that could be brought into this project. And they're not sitting here. We need their input, so that's important. And then the main thing Toronto is lacking is the ability to do creative, magnificent things rather than the dull, boring, everyday thing. The whole money thing is a red herring. There's money all over the place. The developers are clamoring to do all sorts of stuff. The money is there. We just like to think we can piss off and not do anything because it's a bad time to do things. There's never a bad time to do great things. Time we did them.
Great. Tom.
Under doubt. And our belief that there has to be a public component at some stage to completing these projects. And I learned at this table that as part of the EA, the original EA, there was a costing done of benefits to government. Taxes, development fees, and so on, for the original EA in the Lower Don precinct. I think that it would be extremely useful to do that kind of analysis for Toronto or somebody to do that kind of analysis for the entire Portland. Then it seems to me that environmentalists like us who can then go to senior government and say, look, guys, here's some hard numbers.